story. All about power.
Sit right here.
How became the prince of MTC-TV?
Westmount Carmel, born and raised.
My days.
Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool, and shooting some b-ball outside. That's cool. And a couple of guys who were up to no good started causing trouble in my neighborhood. I got one little fight. My mom got scared. She said, "You're gonna go to school and do Aces TV." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my backpack and sent me on the way. She gave me a kiss and she gave me my ticket. I put my AirPods in. I said, "I might as well kick it." First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of champagne glass. This might be alright. I requested an Uber, and when it came near, the license plate said freshman and license year. If anything, I could say this Uber was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it. Yo, home to high school. I pulled up to the school about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the driver, "Yo, home, smell you later." I looked at my king, I was finally there. Sit on my throne, I had no to say.
Hello, and welcome back to Aces TV. I'm Riley Webb.
And I'm Allison Thread. A few beloved sports and extracurriculars from Mount Carmel High School have been postponed until the spring semester. However, the cross-country, boys' golf, girls' golf, and tennis teams are still able to continue with their fall seasons.
One of our very own Aces TV members interviewed several different teammates from each sport and told a story about how it feels to play sports competitively during a pandemic.
Hi, I'm Aggie Boyer. I'm from Aces TV. In this segment, I interviewed the cross-country team, boys' golf, girls' golf, and the tennis girls. I asked them questions about how does it feel to still competitively play during the pandemic, and also how their seasons are panning out so far. A lot of students cannot play their favorite sports and activities right now due to them being moved until the spring semester. However, this inspires a lot of students to join new sports and just try new things. For example, I myself am a band student and my marching band season was postponed until the spring. However, I joined tennis and I'm having a lot of fun right now. So without further ado, let's get on with the segment. Hi, I'm here with the whole cross country team. So how did you guys think you do?
I did pretty well, I'm pretty sure.
I ran fast. I ran not fast.
How about you?
I did okay.
Okay. Well, I'm here with Lily Kepis, Jada Smith, Jayla Smith, Anthony Blyer, Jason Miller, Chase Kepis, Garrick Jones, and Eric Leffler. So is this meet different from any other meets you guys ran? How about you, Jason?
I mean, the course is different than what we ran last year, but it's a little bit shorter than anything we've done so far this year, but yeah.
How about you, Chase?
It was a little bit shorter and less teams than last year, for sure.
So last Thursday, you guys ran against Robinson at home. How did that go?
Well, I got 20.55, so it wasn't, I guess, that bad, but I didn't really, I got seventh, I guess, so that's cool.
Seventh place, that's awesome. What about you, Jason?
I don't know what my place was, but I ran my slowest time that I've run so far this year, so that was cool.
How was that match for you, Gary?
It was hot and sunny.
You're like the fastest runner on this team. How does that make you feel?
Fantastic.
Well, there's other sports that can't do, like football and volleyball, they have to play in the spring. But cross country, tennis, and golf are still playing. So how does it feel to be out here running during this pandemic when other sports can't play? How do you feel about that, Eric?
I mean, it's been all right and everything. We've just been practicing constantly, and it's been going pretty well.
That's awesome. Anthony?
I mean, it's cool because I play golf too. So it's really nice to have both of my main sports able to play. But I guess I kind of feel bad for the sports that can't play.
What about you, Lily?
It's pretty cool.
Well, thank you guys so much. This is the whole cross country team at a successful match in Olney. Hi, I'm here with Coach Vargo, the coach of the cross country team. We are here at Olney. How did you feel about this meet?
I thought the kids ran really well. I'll have to double check the times, but I think every one of the boys and girls all ran their best times of the season today. It's a little bit overcast, a little cooler than what we've had. This course runs pretty fast. And what you're always looking for is improvement, trying to get better every week. And kids have been working hard in practice, and it showed up today.
Well, that's great. So I have this little fun question. What would you say to someone who wants to join cross country?
I would say come out. We're glad to have you. It's a lot of camaraderie here. This is a really tight group. They all get along real well. You know, it running's hard, but they work hard at it, but we also have a lot of fun. And we encourage anybody to come out. I mean, anybody can run. We've got all kinds of talent level. We got some really serious runners, and we got some runners that are kind of conditioning for other sports. But it's just it's a good, healthy exercise. It's something you can do once you graduate from high school. You know, you can keep on running, staying healthy. But yeah, anybody wants to come out and run with us, we'll be glad to have them.
Cross country is definitely a tough sport. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Coach Vargo.
Okay, thank you.
That's awesome.
Hi, I'm here with the boys golf. I'm here with Matt Zimmerman, Jarrett West, and Bo Stiff. So, how does it feel to still be playing golf competitively during this pandemic?
Well, it's been very interesting so far this year. We've had to overcome a lot. We started off pretty strong with our first match and wearing masks and social distancing. And then we had a couple of corona outbreaks and had to stop playing golf for 2 weeks, but now we're back. It's going smoothly. All we want to do is stay safe and continue to play because we love playing golf and keeping our coach safe and all our other players safe. So it's been good.
That's an awesome answer. So you guys have been playing golf this season for a while now. You've had a couple of matches, and you have a match today in Robinson. So how have your matches been so far, and what do you hope for this one? How about you, Jarrett?
They've been going pretty good. Just hoping the best for this tournament, and just hoping we can do okay.
Great answer. So, Bo, your main sports have been postponed until spring, and this is your first time playing golf competitively, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how does that feel? You like it?
It's definitely the hardest sport I've played.
That's awesome. Well, thank you, boys golf, so much, and I hope you have a great match today.
Thank you.
I'm with the girls golf team. I'm with Lily Gottman, Daisy Schrader, and Maddie Young. So I asked the boys golf the same question. How does it feel to be playing golf competitively during this pandemic when other sports like football have to wait until spring? I mean, like cross-country golf and tennis are still the active sports right now.
It feels really good because we've been working all summer, and I'm glad we can have a day off for the season. How about you, Daisy?
It definitely caused a lot of controversy, but I'm glad we can still play.
That's awesome. So for this match, you guys are going to Robinson, is that correct?
Yes.
What are you hoping for this match, and how have your matches been so far? What about you, Maddie?
My matches have been pretty good. I expect to probably win this one since Robinson's a pretty nice course.
I'm not even sure they have a team, so I think we'll win.
So you guys actually came second in state last year, which is amazing. Do you think this will happen again this year, or similar
to that? Since we don't have a state this year, I expect us to at least win our regional since it's on home course, but we do have a pretty interesting player in Madison County, so we have more work cut out for us.
What place did you make last year?
Either 13th or
15th. That's awesome. And Lily?
I think I came in like 23rd, 22nd, something like that.
Daisy?
We won't talk about my position.
Well, thank you girls so much, and I hope you have a great match today. Get along with the boys golf. Have fun.
Thanks.
Thank you.
And lastly, I'm here with the girls tennis team. I'm here with Malia Armstrong and Cameron Strine. So this is easily the biggest girls tennis team Mount Carmel High School has had since a while. So how does that feel, having all of these new players and such a big supportive team?
Well, it's definitely a bigger environment, a lot of girls. There's a lot more love to go around, a lot more cheerleaders to cheer you on. We all help each other in different ways, picking each other up instead of tearing each other down, and it's just, we all work really well together.
And you?
Yeah, I say the same. It's just nice having a good, big team. They have all shown a lot of improvement, and I think it's going to be a really good year.
That's awesome.
Yeah, a lot of players have been joining new sports because of sports cancellations, but it's such a great activity. So today you all have a match against Richland County. What are you expecting for this match, and how have your matches been so far?
Our matches so far have been good, and we've only had a few, but all the girls have played really hard, and they're doing really good. This match, Olney's a hard team, but I think we can hold our own against them.
That's a great spirit. And the last question I have is, how does it feel to still be playing tennis competitively even during a COVID-19 pandemic?
Well, of course, there's a lot of different rules and guidelines that we have to follow, but I think all of us are willing to take the extra precautions just so we can have our season and keep playing. So I think that even though there's a lot of different things, but we're still just happy we get to play.
Well, thank you girls so much. That was Malia and Cammie, and thank you for tuning in. Signing off.
Thank you, Maggie. When volleyball and football collide, exciting things are sure to happen. In this segment, volleyball and football players played a game minute to win it style to celebrate their school spirit and for the sake of it for fun.
Hi, we're back. Okay, today we're doing minute to win it, volleyball versus football. Here's our contestants.
I'm Allie.
I'm Taya.
I'm Sierra.
Okay, I have a question. Allie, how does it feel not getting to play volleyball during your fall season?
It makes us all really sad, but we're hopeful that we'll be able to play in the spring, so that's exciting.
All right, and here are the football boys.
I'm Caleb.
I'm TJ.
I'm Brant.
All right, TJ, are you feeling confident in your competition?
Extremely confident we're going to dominate.
All right, let's see. Our first challenge of the game is going to be the tissue pull. Whoever empties their box first wins, Taya versus Caleb Norick. All right, everybody, on your marks, get set, go. Taya wins!
All right, challenge number two. Volleyball players are up by one. We have Allie McPherson and Brant Salhani. Whoever gets the cookie from their forehead into their mouth first wins. On your mark, get set, go! All right, competition number three, Sierra versus TJ. Whoever gets the most cotton balls into their bowl wins. And this one is going to be worth 3 points. The football players still have a chance to win. All right, on your mark, get set, go!
And they are blindfolded. Their eyes are closed.
All right, time is up. Show your bowls to the camera. Oh no! What an upset. The football players win. Good job, TJ. All right, back to you guys.
Pumpkin spice sweaters, leaf piles, and apple cider are just around the corner.
Although it's not exactly autumn yet, everyone is already pumped up and ready for the beautiful season.
Let's see if our weather expert, Taylor Roosevelt, can show us if we are expecting more hot weather or if we're finally catching a glimpse into the long-awaited autumn season.
Thanks, guys. The radar looks clear. Tonight looks clear with a low of 44. Saturday is sunny with a high of 71, and Sunday is sunny with a high of 74. The extended forecast for the week is Monday with a high of 76, and a low of 49, Tuesday with a high of 78 and a low of 53, Wednesday, high of 81 and a low of 56, Thursday, a high of 82 and a low of 57, Friday, a high of 83 and a low of 57, and it's sunny all week.
And that concludes our segment for today.
Thank you for tuning in to the second episode of ACES TV. We hope we brought smiles to your faces today with these unique segments.
This is Riley Webb
and Allison Thread
signing off.